today we will discuss about the force and pressure chapter from the class 8. There are two sessions of this chapter. In my first session, I will discuss the force. What is force? Force is any push or pull. Obviously, there can be different form like hitting, like drawing, like pulling something. If you want to open a door, in some cases you have to pull and you have to push. So there are different forms, but actually there are the mainly two forms, which is the push and pull. So in science we define the force as a push or pull. So in about the force, this pull or push or the force come into action when the object going to be interact with each other. It means the interaction which can be direct or indirect. Okay, between the object is very important. Okay, so the necessary condition for force to come into action is the direct or indirect interaction between the object. Then force. If we apply the force on an object in same direction, okay, suppose here is the 5 newton, here it is 3 newton, these force are going to be added. Here 5 newton plus 3 newton is equal to 8 newton force in the east direction. Here. So what I want to tell here, that force is that quantity which is having direction. If the force on body applies in different directions, suppose it is 5 newton, here it is 3 newton, it is toward east, it is toward west, then the 5 newton minus 3 newton is equal to 2 newton in east direction. Again, it shows that force is having the direction. Okay. Then second thing. I am saying 5 newton, 3 newton, 5 plus 3, 8 newton, 2 newton. Means this is larger than this one. And the 8 newton is larger than 5 newton and 3 newton. Because it is, it is added. Here the 2 newton is less, meaning that this physical quantity is having magnitude, meaning it is having some numerical value. So it is having magnitude, that means it is having the numerical value, which means because of these we can compare that which one is large and which one is a smaller, or what quantity of force is going to apply it on an object. So it is that quantity which is having direction as well as magnitude. On the basis of this, or the any physical quantity which is having direction as well as magnitude, is known as your vector quantity. Okay. Then one more thing about the force is that its SI unit is newton. So I had just give the suffix newton. Okay, 5 newton, 3 newton, 2 newton, means that newton is the SI unit. We will find the another unit how we get it. For example, actually F is equal to m into a, mass into acceleration. Mass used to be kilogram in SI unit and acceleration meter square, and it should be this one, but we also use this. SI unit is newton. So it was the force. Now let's see what is the balanced and unbalanced force. About direct and indirect interaction, we will see when we discuss about the type of forces. So first of all, at first we are discussing that balanced and unbalanced force. What is this? Suppose it is the object A. We are applying the force 5 Newton. And here 5 Newton in east direction and here the 5 Newton in west direction. What will be the net force? Net force will be 5 Newton minus 5 Newton, which is equal to 0. Okay. There can be more forces like that again at object A, 3 Newton, then here the 5 Newton, here it is 5 Newton. What will be here? The vertical, it will be nullified, this one, this will be nullified by this. So again, the net force in case of the balanced force is 0. Because of this, as there is no force, so there will be no change in the object. No change. Okay. But in case of the unbalanced force, suppose it is the object B, we are applying the force 5 Newton here. Again, 5 Newton here. What will happen? This will be added 5 Newton plus 5 Newton is equal to 10 Newton. Means it will be go toward the east direction. Or if your object be again 5 Newton force, 3 Newton force in opposite direction, what will be then? 5 Newton minus 3 Newton, which is equal to 2 Newton in east direction. Meaning that the unbalanced force is having the non-zero value. Non-zero value. Due to this, we just explain it, net force is equal to non-zero. Okay, then one more thing. Due to this, as the force is going to be acted here or it comes in action, so there will be the change in the state of motion or shape. We will see what can be effects of the force. So it was about the balanced force and the unbalanced force. Now let us see what are the different effects of the force. Force can affect the object's state of motion. Then the question comes, what is the state of motion? State of motion. Suppose any object is at rest, means it is not having any speed, then it is its state of motion, means it is a rest, in rest motion. If the object is in continuous in speed, means it is in dynamic state. Okay, but at the time when it is having some speed, obviously it is having the direction. Okay, so the speed, it can be at rest motion or it can be dynamic motion, we call it dynamic motion. In this there will be speed as well as direction. Okay, and the force can change the state of motion, means it changes the speed of the object and it can change the direction of object. A very simple example I'll tell you, which is very familiar with you in your daily life, that you all use bicycle. When you brake, when you apply brake, what happens? Its speed reduces. When you increase your pedaling, what happens? Its speed increases. When you handle or when you apply the force to handle in particular direction, it turns in that particular direction, means it can change the direction. So it can change the speed, which can be increased or decreased, or if the object is at rest, it can be coming to speed, or if the object in speed, it can be come into rest position. Along with this, it changes its direction. One more important thing is that, as I have told, the state of motion it can change. Then the second, it can change the shape of object. Applying the force, we can change the shape of any object. For example, in case of inflated balloon, you press that balloon, what happened? Its shape changes. Most probably, I'm sure you all have seen your mother to making dough from wheat flour. What happened? She just applied some force and gave a particular shape to that dough. And by applying again the force, she gave you a circular form or disc shaped chapatis. So, means that force give or affect the shape of the object, it can change. So, there are three effects of force. It can change direction, speed. Commonly we call it the state of motion, and the third is your shape. So it was about the state of, it was about the effect of the force. Now let's see what are the different types of force. At first I have said about the term direct and indirect interaction. If we push something, we have to touch it. If we pull something, we have to touch it. Is it always universal? No. For example, if I just give this, I have what actually I did. I thrown this marker to upward, automatically it come to downward without touching, without any interaction, which we can actually see. But there was interaction. The earth was pulling this marker downward without indirect interaction. That interaction was indirect interaction. So, on the basis of interaction, which can be direct or indirect, force can be of contact force, okay? Indirect interaction. Okay. So it can be contact force, and here it can be non-contact force. So in case of the indirect interaction, it is of three types. We just see in our daily life. First it is gravitational force. Second, electrostatic force. Static force. And third, your magnetic force. Magnetic force. Here you can observe muscular force, then frictional force. About friction, we will discuss in our next chapter of class 8 in detail, but here I will just introduce this term. So, muscular force. When we do something, for example, I have done this or I move my hand, so here we need some muscular force. If I just start writing, I have to push on this marker. So in case of the muscular force, there is a direct contact between the object is important. So that is your muscular force. When our muscles come into action or applies the force, then it is a muscular force. Then the frictional force. It is that particular type of force which applies on object when the two objects come in contact, means their surfaces come in contact, and the direction of this force is always opposite to the direction of the object moving. For example, if there is a ball moving here on the earth surface, this surface of the ball comes in contact with the surface of earth, and the frictional force will apply here in this direction if the ball is moving in this direction. So it is your frictional force. Always it is opposite in direction. Opposite in direction of moving object. Very important example. In case of the ball we play, we just throw, after some time it reduces its speed, and after some more time it finally comes into rest just because of the frictional force. So gravitational, come to the gravitational force. I have just demonstrated that this marker will come down when I just drop it from here, because the earth attracted toward the gravitational toward it. The property of earth due to which it attracts any object is known as the gravity. But is the gravitational force is a quality of earth? No. In universe, any heavy object always attract to other heavy object, means it is the force of attraction applied between the two heavy objects. It is like gravitational force F is equal to G. There it is a constant, gravitational constant. M2, mass of two objects, by R square, that is the distance between them. As heavy the object will be, the force of attraction will be more, and as they are closer, the force of attraction will be higher. So we'll see it in our later classes. It was just introduction that it is the gravitational force which applies to any heavy object in the universe. As the mass is high, the gravitational force will be high. As the distance is low, again the gravitational force will be high. So due to gravity, which is a non-contact force, the object comes toward the earth. Then electrostatic force. Obviously, you have done some example, like if you rub this marker, which is of plastic or any non-conducting material, if we rub it here and we just try to, we rub this marker, then what happens? It will get charged. This charged marker will attract the small bits of small paper. So, which is the uncharged? That is the example of electrostatic friction. Because of rubbing, this gets charged, and that small bits of paper are very small and uncharged. This charged particle can attract the uncharged particle. This type of force is your electrostatic. Here the important thing is that charged object attracts the uncharged object. Okay. Then the last, your magnetic force. Obviously, you all have seen the magnet having the north and south pole. If it is north, it is south pole. It doesn't matter that how small the magnet is. If it is magnet, then there will be the two poles, that is south and north. In case of this magnet attracts any iron object. We know this one thing, and the second thing, it attracts the magnet of different or unlike pole and ripple the like it is very important. On the basis of this repulsion, we can decide whether it is magnet or it is iron. So what happened in case of this? Let us see actually what happened. So it was about the non-contact and contact proof. Let's see about the magnet and its quality in short. If it is magnet, north and south pole, and I am again putting one more magnet toward it, having the light poles toward each other, what will happen? They will repel each other. In second case, it is north, it is south, there is another magnet, north pole toward the south, what will happen? It will be attracted to each other. Or in same, it can be like this, north, south, south, north, again it will be attracted. Okay? Magnet will always attract iron object. So on the basis of its repulsion, we can decide whether it is magnet or not. So it was about the force in this force and pressure chapter. About pressure, we will discuss in our next session. I hope it will help you to understand the topic force, and some questions we will discuss in our next session. Thank you very much.